watching News 8 Now. I'm Meghan Torjussen. The big storm is heading our way tonight, but drivers got a tune-up this morning. Some areas got as much as 2 inches this morning, leading to slippery driving conditions and traffic delays across southern and central Maine. Authorities say there were a number of accidents, including this one, where a car crashed into a house on Cumberland Avenue near Mellon Street. So far, there haven't been any reports of any serious injuries. The man charged with murder and the death of a man last Friday in Vassalboro is arraigned in Kennebec Superior Court. Courtney Shea is accused of killing 69-year-old Thomas Namer of Waterville. Police arrested Shea Friday on an unrelated probation violation. According to court documents, Shea told three family members that he'd killed Namer. The documents say Shea killed Namer after he made a sexual advance. Shea told police that he suffers from post-traumatic stress disorder after being sexually abused by Namer as a child. Shea is being held without bail pending a hearing on December 5th. Well, nationwide, homelessness is on a steady decline, yet here in Maine, we're seeing a 26% increase, and that's according to a report released by the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development. The unemployment rate is falling, but representatives from Preble Street Shelter say this is because the recession is just now hitting some people. He says subsidy cuts and a lack of affordable housing contribute to homelessness. Meanwhile, the deal with Iran to scale back its nuclear program could have an impact on gas prices. The deal will also lift some economic sanctions that should bring about a rise in gas production and hopefully translates into lower gas prices. According to industry analyst Oppenheimer Oil, there could be as much as a 50-cent drop in gas per gallon come this summer. Thank you for tuning in to this News 8 Now update. Make sure to check back with us.